so excited.
Oh my goodness,
to meet
thank you.
You guys.
Are you kidding me? You know you're Drew Barrymore, right?
No, I do not. I wouldn't even know what that means. And yet I get so excited, like I'm so starstruck by you guys because this Aww. Is my new favorite book. It's
That's
the
so
most
sweet.
Incredible, beautiful, whimsical.
Thank you.
It's I wrote when my kids were little. We read a lot of books to Erin and her brother, Nate. And somewhere in the course of reading all these books, I thought, I want my kids to think that they could write. Oh, that's a picture I've never seen. and I want them to write some poems. So we'd write poems together at night during reading time. This is that book. I
this
put
is
it
the
in here.
Book, yeah. And do
yeah,
you...
take a look and
oh
you'll
my
see.
Gosh.
It's just a bunch of loose pages mostly, and sometimes kids wrote them.
And while the pandemic was happening, is this when this got unearthed?
Yeah. It was, I had been going to Pratt Institute in Brooklyn for art, and I came home because everything was closed, and I finished my semester on Zoom. And then it was the summer, and my dad came knocking on my door, and he was like, what if we try to make this a real thing? At the very least, it'll be a fun project and like an update to this family memento. And then cut to like a year and a half of hard work later, and it was sold, and we had a cover, and it looked like a real thing that yeah. you're now holding.
It's such a real thing. Like, oh, funny enough, it opened up to one of my favorite stories, which is Umbrella Practice. Will you guys please tell the story of what Umbrella Practice
yeah,
is, which is two pages of this book, but the story.
The story is, she grew up in L.A., and there's umbrellas in the closet. What do they do? Yes, I know. And I thought, my kids need to know how to work an umbrella. And so they went in the back. I said, we're doing Umbrella Practice. Here you go. Each of you take one. I got the hose, sprayed it into the air, only for a few minutes. Don't worry. Come on. Don't sue me. And there she is. There's Erin and Nate out back in the backyard practicing with the umbrella. They loved
it. Was so
it.
Fun.
They loved
so
it.
Fun.
I mean, I'm sorry. But, like, did you grow up in a fantasy?
A little bit. I mean, Hollywood, you never know. But he was a great dad. He was always there. He was my soccer coach.
I really enjoyed being a dad.
What do you think it is that inspired you to be that kind of whimsical parent?
Oh, I've always been very silly. I mean, my response to the challenges of life and to the stresses of life, and I grew up in a house that had some stress in it because my dad had a problem with the drink. And, my response, the place I went, was just being funny and silly. And I had an audience, because I'm from a family of seven. So we all laughed and joked. So it came from my childhood.
And I've had this epiphany. I've tried to sum it up in a way that I think I'm getting closer to, which is that we are like links in this chain of a family. And with each link comes the next human that says, I want to pull this from the previous link.
Yeah. Mm.
And I'd like to change this in my link.
Yeah.
And even though that was the kind of parent you had,
yeah.
I'm not the kind of parent my
right.
parents were.
Right.
You can improve
yes.
on the link.
Yes.
I think you guys are making one of the most beautiful links I have ever seen with this book.
Well, thank you yeah. so much. I mean, it was written with a kid, right? So I'd write a line, the kid would write a line, but I was writing as much to them, to myself, as a kid.
How so?
Well, there's a lot of poems in there. There's a lot of poems in there about supporting yourself. And there's a couple poems that are about a kid having a bad day or screwing up, but being resilient and being upbeat about it or even humorous about it towards themselves. And that's an attitude that I didn't have as a kid. And I learned it as I got older and saw it in other people and thought, wow, it doesn't mean you don't admit that you made a mistake. It doesn't mean that you don't admit that you failed or had something go wrong. It just means you don't let it hit you so hard.
Oh, God.
And you smile and maybe laugh and say, I'm going to go at it again tomorrow. But when I look at it...
When did you learn that? Because this, I think,
I'll tell you the truth.
Human's biggest epidemic is if we make mistakes, we come down on ourselves as if we have just ruined everything in life and it's so bad. And mistakes are so important and necessary and unavoidable in order to grow. I have a new definition of regret. It's like, regret is so heavy and depressing. I'm like, ugh. You say regret and it just, the whole room shuts down. It's a bummer, man. Yeah. It's just got so much baggage. It can't be freed of it. However, I'm like, what's a new word for when you make a mistake and you go, I will not do that again.
Mm. Yeah.
I've learned something.
Yeah.
I won't repeat.
Yeah.
I need that word. I need a sexy
version. Well, I have to come up with that word.
Please, please.
I'll work on it.